Welcome back. Let's check in now with meteorologist Molly Matott with a look at this afternoon's forecast. We were just talking about another big nor'easter heading up the coast.
Third one in 2 weeks. Wow. So we had the forecasters in the New England coast have been very busy. Lucky for us, this is going to be another miss for us, but big impacts in places like New York City, Boston, parts of Massachusetts, near Cape Cod have blizzard warnings up right now.
Wow, and travel plans for people here.
Exactly. We're going to be watching those flights in and out of Syracuse along the eastern seaboard, but for us, like I mentioned, it's a miss. In fact, right now, a triple Doppler radar brought to you by Fossil Service Experts. Very dry. It's a clean sweep. We even had some breaks of sunshine this morning. Clouds are on the increase, so skies will trend grayer as we head into the afternoon. And it's all about this guy. This is the low pressure system that's eventually going to slip off the coast and become that nor'easter. It's thickening clouds right now. It will pump in some moisture to get some flurries going by the ride home from work and some light snow overnight. While this is not a direct hit for us, it is going to influence our forecast for almost the entire work week. Let me show you how this happens with the storm tracker. Pick it up today at noon. There's that area of low pressure that's trying to move off the coast. It does so later on today, and then once it does, it kind of redevelops, strengthens, and starts to head to the north. Takes a more northeasterly path, and that's why this is not a direct hit for us. It pushes off the coast, but you can see big snow for Boston, New York, into New England. For us, what this will do is give several periods of light accumulating snow, the first of which comes late evening, overnight tonight, and through Tuesday morning. As I stop the future cast at 8 o'clock, you can see there's some light snow around places in central New York, and this is most focused the 81 corridor and eastward. Further west you go, maybe a coating to an inch. Over here is where we have maybe a few inches stacking up by early Tuesday morning. Here's the deal, is even as that low pressure system exits to the east, it still has enough energy and wraparound moisture to keep snow showers in the forecast for the entire day on Tuesday. We'll watch that wraparound moisture, and then eventually we'll be watching the winds starting Tuesday night into Wednesday. The circulation around this gets our winds out of the northwest. That kicks off even more moisture off of Lake Ontario and brings in some lake effect for the daytime on Wednesday. So we go from the storm system missing us to some light snow around tonight and Tuesday, and eventually we'll be tracking some tricky lake effect Wednesday into Thursday, and there may even be some flurries around for Friday as well. So let's take you through this period by period. Snowfall forecast tonight as that light snow moves in. I think it's a coating to maybe 2 inches along the 81 corridor and westward through the Finger Lakes. This is really focused to the east. If you live east of 81, good chance you'll have 2 to 4 inches on the ground by early tomorrow morning. That's not a whole lot, but it will impact travel. We'll have some slick roads, especially on the side streets. So make sure you are giving yourself some extra time to get where you need to go tomorrow morning. Now, during the daytime, like I mentioned, wraparound moisture and a little bit of lake enhancement. Coating to an inch for most of us, but it's over the higher elevations to the southeast and to the east of the lake, the Tug, the hill south of Syracuse, an additional 1 to 3 inches. And then we continue to add on, slowly but surely, more accumulation as we head into the end of the week. Let's show you that with our 7-day forecast. Notice the temperatures are below normal. We should be hitting highs in the low 40s. We're barely in the low 30s for the work week. We turn blustery with lake snow Wednesday. That slowly tapers off Friday. Looks like we could be dry for parade day on Saturday. And you can track all of this with interactive Doppler online at cnycentral.com.